If You Lived in Colonial Times by Anne McGovern, illustrated by June Otani. Welcome to part 6 of the video series, If You Lived in Colonial Times. In this video, the following questions will be answered. What did a colonial house look like? How many rooms did a colonial house have? Did big families live in big houses? What did the furniture look like? What did people sleep on? Where did people hang their clothes? Where did people take baths? What did colonial houses look like? Houses in early colonial days were not big or fancy, and they were not warm. In wintertime, a colonial house was so cold that if you were writing a letter, the ink might freeze right on your pen. To make the house warmer, the people burned giant logs in the fireplace. Some logs were so big that it took 2 horses to drag them into the house. How many rooms did a colonial house have? Houses in early colonial days had 1 room. It was called the keeping room. The family cooked and ate and worked in the keeping room. Here, too, the grown-ups and the babies slept. Older children slept in the attic. Did big families live in big houses? When more and more children were born, the family needed more and more space, so they built more rooms. No matter how big the house was, the family still kept using the keeping room for cooking, eating, sleeping, and working. There were many kinds of houses. One kind of house looked like the box in which salt was kept in colonial days. It is still called a salt box house today. What did the furniture look like? Most people had plain furniture. They made it themselves. They didn't make much furniture because there was not much room to put it in. In many houses, there was only 1 chair. It belonged to the father. No one else was allowed to sit in it. The rest of the family sat on wooden benches, or they sat on the settle. The settle was a long wooden bench with high sides and a high back. It was not comfortable, but at least it was warm in the winter. The high sides and the high back kept out the chilling winds that blew through the house. What did people sleep on? Mothers and fathers slept in a jack bed. The jack bed was short to save space. Mothers and fathers did not sleep stretched out. The bed was not long enough. The jack bed was high so that a smaller bed for the younger child could fit under it. The smaller bed was called a trundle bed. At night, the trundle bed was pulled out from under the jack bed. Babies slept in their cradles near the fireplace. Older children slept in the attic on bags filled with stretchy straw, or on softer mattresses filled with feathers or bits of wool. Where did people hang their clothes? People hung their clothes on pegs on the wall. Where did people take baths? There were no bathrooms in a colonial house. There was no running water either. People had to go outside the house for their water. They carried water home from the well in wooden buckets. There was no way to make sure that the water was pure, so they did not often drink it. They did not often bathe in it either. When they did take a bath, they stood up in a big wooden tub of water in front of the fireplace. This concludes part 6 of the video series, If You Lived in Colonial Times.